Kia is most likely one of the best brands at the moment releasing electric cars. They have released the Kia EV6, which is a premium SUV coupe. After this, they released the Kia EV9, which is a 7-seater electric SUV. One of the best electric SUVs that's a 7-seater that you can currently buy. After this, they are going to release the Kia EV4 hatchback and saloon, as well as the Kia EV5. But first, this is the next electric car. It is the Kia EV3, and it is about Kia Sportage size. Let's have a look and see what it is like, and let's see if it's not only the best Kia, but also the best electric car ever. Hello everyone, welcome to Everything Cars & More. This is the number one place to be for car news and reviews. Sit back, buckle up, let's go. So the overall design of the Kia EV3 is very similar to the Kia EV9, but it is more rounded and more younger looking. It makes it more attractive to the younger generation, which I do quite like. To start with, we get a set of daytime running lights on top of the main headlight unit and down the side of the main headlight unit to give it a concept style look. We also get pixel style headlight units like what we see on the EV9, which makes this car look very modern. Lower down we get an exaggerated air vent with a smaller vent lower down. And we also don't get any side vents this time, which is unusual, but it is slowly becoming more common on electric cars. We also get some shiny silver bits on the front too. Moving around to the side, and we get a chunky design to it. To start with, it has a boxy look with boxy proportions and boxy black cladded wheel arches too. We also get some shiny lower skirts and some boxy style wheel designs. The creases are also quite sharp to help with the boxy look. We also get flush door handles and a hidden rear door handle, just like what the Renault Clio has. The overall proportions also make the car look smaller than what it actually is, helping the car to look youthful. Move around to the back, and the Kia EV3 is just like the front in terms of similar design to the EV9, but this time it is a more youthful look. To start with, we get these tail lights that go down the sides of the car just like a Volvo, but they also go onto the boot to give it this interesting look. The graphics also have an interesting pattern, just like other Kias that are starting to come out now. These tail lights are also connected with a black bar and a bit like what the Kia Soul had. And this isn't surprising, as the Kia EV3 is going to be a spiritual successor to the Kia Soul. Lower down on the bumper, we get some shiny silver panels and some black panels with a texture on it. We also get some reflectors too, and of course the number plate. Right, let's have a look at what battery and motor options you can have with the new Kia EV3. So, the battery and motor lineup of the new Kia EV3 is quite simple. There is only one motor option and two battery options at the moment. Let's start with the base configuration first. This has a 58.3 kWh battery pack with a single motor making 201 brake horsepower, and this is mounted on the front to give it front wheel drive. All of this means you get 267 miles of range and a 0-62 time of about 7.5 seconds, which isn't that bad, and it doesn't feel like you need more power. The next version uses the same 201 brake horsepower motor, but this time you get a bigger battery pack at 81.4 kWh in size, and this gives you a range of about 372 miles. But bear in mind that the 0-62 time does drop slightly to 7.7 seconds because of the heavier battery pack, so that may have to be a compromise you have to make if you want the extra range. You also get DC peak charging rate of 128 kilowatts, which will fill the battery up from 10 to 80% in about 30 minutes. The smaller battery only charges at 102 kilowatts, but it does fill it up as quickly because it's a smaller size. You also get a vehicle to load function, so you can plug domestic items in the car. The price of the new Kia EV3 starts at £32,995, which is quite good for an electric car. The trim levels you can get consist of Air, GT Line and GT Line S. Right, let's have a look at the interior. So climbing inside the new Kia EV3, we get a sense of openness inside. We get a very minimalistic dashboard, but it is functional. To start with, we get this digital panel which houses three screens. You get your digital instrument cluster as well as your infotainment system, which is running the latest Kia infotainment system software. And this is like what you will find in the Kia EV9 and EV6 facelift. It works well and is very easy to use like other Kia infotainment systems from the past. In the middle of these screens though, we get your climate control screen. Now, this is available on the Kia EV9, and as I have said in that review, I am not sure of this screen, as it means that only the driver can control the climate control. Now, we do get some buttons for the climate control in the middle of the dashboard, so the passenger does have some control, but then that makes the middle screen feel pointless in my opinion. Talking of buttons in the middle of the dashboard, we also get some radio shortcuts too, and just below that your air vents. Now, we don't get a centre console as such in this car, which does make it feel very open, but it also means that for drivers who like to feel cocooned won't be able to in this type of car. This does make up loads of space though inside, which is quite nice, and you also get a centre console nearer the seat which has an armrest and some buttons on it. The indicator stalks are typical Kia stalks, but we do get a gear select to lower down, just like what the Hyundai Ioniq 5 has. We also get the new style Kia steering wheel, which I do quite like. It does have the usual Kia buttons, but it does come in two different designs depending on trim level, and it can also be had in a dual tone effect, which is also very premium. The door card is also the same usual Kia buttons, but it also has ambient lighting as well as your heated seat switches too. Overall then, it's not too bad in here. Right, let's have a look and see what the rear seats are like. So getting into the back of the Kia EV3, we get a decent amount of legroom and headroom. This is to be expected in this size of car. We also get some air vents too, as well as an armrest and some USB-C ports in the backs of the front seats. These seats though, I'm not too sure about the rear design for my personal taste, but it is something I could get used to. Sitting free in the back is easy, as the middle seat is quite wide and there isn't much of a hump in the floor. We also get a decent amount of storage, and the materials in the back are quite good too. Let's have a look and see what the boot is like. So, opening the boot to the Kia EV3, and you are welcomed with 460 litres of space with the seats up. This is smaller than the Kia Sportage, but it is bigger than the Kia Soul, Volvo EX30, Smart Hashtag 1, and is on par with the Mini Countryman Electric. Folding the seats down, and you are welcomed with 1,251 litres. This isn't that bad for the type of car you are getting, and you also get a front boot with 25 litres of space, and this is enough for your charging cables. Only the Volvo EX30 and the Smart Hashtag 1 have a front boot, but the Kia EV3's is bigger and more usable. So, what do I think of the new Kia EV3 then? Well, for the price of car, you are getting a premium feeling family electric SUV, which is very good, and it also has a 7-year warranty, and it is also very affordable on running costs too. Compared to its rivals, Kia has done mostly everything correctly, and it is worth putting it up high on your list, as it has the looks inside and out, but also the practicality to go with it. It is most possibly one of the best electric affordable family SUVs you can go for at the moment. If you like this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video.